Welcome, dear viewers, to Couch Warrior TV on YouTube. I am the Couch Warrior, and you are watching The Passage, a Skyrim SE Let's Play. Featuring Ettient Jorel, the Ultmer Ranger. The hound has not gotten much sleep. It was a long night. He came back and we gotta stay out of this one. Vampires. The Arcane Ring. Khajiit claws do 4 times the damage of a man's punch. Huh.
Vampire so much as scratches you, you'll turn into one. That better not be true.
Guess Ettient would hope so as well.
The fairest prices and the highest quality in Skyrim.
Hey, I think the threat is over. Geez, I hope it still holds water.
Looking to stay alive? Why take a chance?
Look at this mess.
Gems, potions, exotic ingredients. I have them all.
Jewelry with legendary. The Argonian craftsmanship.
What a mess.
Buy some armor and live to tell about it.
Vegetables as crisp as a winter's morning.
Rare trinkets and the finest oddities from... Can I interest you in some fine goods from everything I've got on display, really?
Ooh, he's got a grand soul gem. It's expensive, but we'll sock that away. All right. Arcane Ring. So, am I correct in assuming that this just benefits Khajiits then? Because the guy we got it from certainly wasn't a Khajiit. Not really sure how to take that exactly. Well, we can certainly get rid of all of this weight.
Your eyes to the road.
Clean and free from rock joints.
Well, as you probably noticed, Ettient is all geared up this morning.
Come to see what brings you to Balamut today? Repair? The finest weapons and armor.
He got very little sleep last night, but he woke up determined. And he's got an agenda in mind. Ebony ingots. Look at that. We don't need 8 of them. That would be a bit much. But we'll take 2.
If you need any more smithing work, come see me again.
I figure it's probably good policy for Ettient to just try and have a couple of ebony ingots in his inventory all the time, just in case he's in a position to make more arrows or needs more arrows or whatever. He's got what he needs. I hope you all are doing well. I am doing great. It's been interesting. A lot of fun creating this story now that we're really getting deep into the twists and turns of the plot and stuff, right? It seems like ages ago that we were skulking around the Reach, building our strength. And now here we are, going on level 36.
Welcome to the cozy little family. I'm one of the lookouts for the guild.
Hey, you're Delvin, right?
Watch Delvin's back.
Brynjolfi, let me guess. He just plucked you off the street and dropped you into the thick of things without telling you which way is up. Am I right?
That's pretty much right.
See, that kind of attitude comes from someone who wants to get rich and stay alive long enough to enjoy it. We're gonna get along nicely. So, if you've got the nerve, I've got plenty of extra jobs to help get the guild back on its feet.
Back on its feet, eh?
Look around you. The flagon, the guild, it's all falling apart. A few decades ago, this place was as busy as the Imperial City. Now, you'd be lucky if you don't trip over a skeever instead.
I can vouch for that. So what's happened?
Look, I know the others think I'm a bit dull for saying stuff like this, but I'm gonna give it you straight. Something out there is piss drunk mad at us. I don't know who or what it is, but it's beyond just you and me. We've been cursed.
Curse. What can we do about that?
I'll tell you what we do. We spit in that curse's face and turn things around down here. Put things back the way they were. That's where you come in. I've got plenty of work available that could guide us down the road to recovery. All you need to do is ask, and we can both come out of this smelling like a rose.
All right. Hey, can I sell this statue to you? I really don't need this weighing me down.
Well, well. I was looking for this little beauty. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. There you go. This should cover it.
Hey, listen. Someone's paid me to steal Maven Blackbriar's horse. I haven't exactly done it yet. I haven't converted on this thing. What do you think I should do?
Who in their right mind would be stupid enough to pay you to steal from Maven?
Sibby.
Guess I should have known. Maven and Sibby have been at odds ever since she had him tossed into jail. Look, if I were you, I'd proceed carefully. Crossing Maven is one of the first things you learn not to do
with your dad here. As far as the guild's concerned, this is between Sibby and Maven, so we're going to officially stay out of it.
Good advice. All right, I'll talk to you later.
Could I give you a little tip? Take every job you can get, or else you'll end up a beggar.
Even if you're one of us, you better not make trouble.
Ettient showed Delvin Mallory, I think, the proper amount of respect. After all, he's a veteran of the Thieves Guild. And he has written a book that we are carrying around in our backpack right now, which says something about his intelligence and his commitment. All of that. Hey, boss.
Word on the street is Golden Glow's been hit. Good job, lad.
Yeah, here's what was in the safe.
Let me take a look at what you found. Arengoth sold Golden Glow? What's that idiot thinking? He has no idea the extent of Maven's fury when she's been cut out of a deal. But I'm certain he'll find out.
Well, he was only the parchment pretty scared when we talked to him.
Odd symbol. Any idea what that might be?
I don't know.
Blast. Well, I'll check my sources and speak to Mercer. But for now, you're off to speak to Maven Blackbriar.
Oh, great.
She asked for you by name.
I thought I did the job like you asked.
No. Nothing like that. You're calling on her for business.
What does she want from me?
That's between you and Maven, and I prefer to keep it that way. Don't worry about it. Maven's business dealings usually involve quite a bit of gold for her people.
Speaking of which...
Of course. Your pay. You're smart as a whiplot. Keep doing right by us, and there's plenty more where that came from.
All right.
Until next we meet, lad.
All right. Off we go to have a conversation. I suppose with the devil, in a way. In this case, a Daedric Prince, maybe? All right.
Rare trinkets and the finest oddities from Morrowind.
We'll see what she has to say.
If you're looking for a handout, you'll want to speak with my husband. If you're looking for company, I suppose I could do worse.
Still trying. No thanks.
If you've got the coin, you've come to the right place. Pull up a seat.
You have some nerve coming back here after what you did to Kirava.
If you've got the coin, you're welcome here. Otherwise, hit the road.
What do you got for sale?
Take a look.
Okay. So, we're going to buy some cooked beef. The venison chop. And in exchange... Thought maybe I could sell her that uncooked pheasant breast, but I'm pretty sure it's considered stolen.
What can I get you? Meat? Wine?
Now, I'm going to use your cook pot for a moment. Did you know your man sold you out?
Looking for a place to stay?
Yeah. I'm tired of him giving us the third degree every time we come in here. Okay, can we cook it? Yeah. All right. That'll be suitable for the trail.
Yeah? What's your problem?
Ma'am?
So you're the one. You don't look so impressive.
How about we skip the conversation?
You're a firebrand, aren't you? It's about time Brynjolf sent me someone with business sense. I was beginning to think he was running some sort of beggar's guild over there.
No faith in the guild?
Faith? I don't have faith in anyone. All I care about is cause and effect. Did the job get done, and was it done correctly? There's no gray area.
Where do I begin?
Head to the Bannered Mare in Whiterun and look for Malus Machius. He'll fill you in on all the details.
Who runs the show at the meadery?
Some layabout named Sabjorn. Been a thorn in my side for the last few years now. One more time, in case I wasn't clear. You butcher this job, and you will be sorry. Shouldn't you be on your way to Whiterun?
Are you aware there's a plot to steal your horse?
Don't tell me. Sibby and Louis Latrush? Well, Sibby is in jail, and Latrush is certainly welcome to try. My hired help is more than a match for him. One more time, in case I wasn't clear. You butcher this job, and you will be sorry.
Don't push me, lady. Any more than you already have, anyway, I suppose. It's time to move out. We've got our marching orders. So we're all geared up. We've got all of our food gear taken care of. We got the house locked up tight. We're good to go.
Ain't no doubt about it. Thieves Guild is back. And they've got rifting in their gear.
Thieves Guild is back. That's the word on the street is. Hey, the Khajiits are back again already. Hey, how you doing?
So many refuse to talk to us. They call us thieves and smugglers. I am glad to see that you are not such a one. Take a look.
Well, now people are spilling over with ebony. But what I'm really after is another grand soul gem. All right. We've got at least two now. We had to purchase those, but that's okay. We'll probably find the rest we need on the trail. So, I mentioned earlier that he was determined. It's time to find Garm. See if we can track down our companion. He misses his friend. And he's been handed a gift. that should allow him to track down Garm. So he's going to try. And if we're lucky, it'll help. It'll actually, you know, lead us in somewhat the right direction, the direction we're going anyway. But the potion of cure disease, that's why we keep a couple on us at all times for occasions like this. Ironically, I think those are the two dogs that we left alive last time we came through here. And they stuck around to get us on the return trip, complete with a disease. How nice. Ah. Where is it? Get to cover. There's anything that we've learned from past experience. Get to cover. Bastard's gonna terrorize this whole river valley. We're gonna have to take him out sooner or later. But he's being pretty cagey. Etienne's also considering Garm, thinking about what, if anything, he could do to train, you know, to help prepare a dog for the eventuality of a dragon fight. I mean, it's interesting to consider how
God might get nervous. A man approaches with his weapon.
You go ahead and get nervous. I don't mind. A citizen might get nervous with guards on the take. How about that? This way? What? Where are you, Garm? In all of our travels with Garm, which were fairly extensive, Ettient is trying to remember if he ever remembers anything on Garm that could have possibly been a charm, you know? Obviously, the idea here is, as far as he can tell, is that there are two linked magic items. Two items of power, one on the dog and one on the dog's owner, or in our case, partner. And if you have one, you're able to locate the other. Legion soldiers. We better get off the road. The lack of sleep is starting to catch up with us as well. Pretty typical of soldiers to waste the hide. Yep. That's what happens to soldiers. They become complacent. They get so used to having all of their meals provided that they don't think about where their next one might be coming from. That's part of the reason why Ettient enjoyed being a scout. Enjoyed being among the ranks of the Rangers. They were always in the field at all times. No one was making sure they were fed, you know? They had to be completely self-sufficient. Certainly hope that Garm is okay, that we find this charm, and that Garm is still attached to it. Also typical of soldiers that they roll through the territory. Killing things. You can track them by just following the blood trails in the bodies. Clearly, Ettient doesn't have a whole ton of respect for that style of soldiery. But that's to be expected. Okay, we got a crossroad here. More often than not, there were probably many situations where the Ranger and Scout Corps were responsible for trying to bring meat back to the military camp to supplement whatever they had in their supply train. My guess is it probably wasn't much appreciated. It's kind of interesting, I think, to think about that part of his life, you know? What that must have been like. Living as a soldier, you know? Garm. Hey, girl. Where you been? Hey. What's going on? Good girl. Stay still, girl. I gotta look through your fur. There's the charm. Well? What are you doing here? Kine's fire. You hear faint whispers in an ancient tongue. Why are you here? Emblem 1. Before the birth of men, the dragons ruled all Mundus. Their word was the voice, and they spoke only for true needs. For the voice could blot out the sky and flood the land. These are the steps, aren't they? Come on, girl, let's go. It's in there. Were you living in there? You've been living in there this whole time? Huh. Come on, let's go. Garm's probably been up here already. We may never get another chance. The rate things are going. This is what Jarl Balgruuf told him to do. Said he'd made this pilgrimage himself. Like we're not the only one doing it. Emblem 2. Men were born and spread over the face of Mundus. The dragons presided over the crawling masses. Men were weak then and had no voice. Are you ready? Let's go. Hey girl, we're gonna have to make camp soon. Man. You really get a sense for the power of that bow, the way that it just sends a tremor through this giant troll when it hits. It's kind of amazing. What's this? Oh. Trouble ahead. Finish it, Garm. Good girl. Well done. Look, another tablet. Woo! Excuse me. I sneezed there and my mouse went all wonky. Woo! Up here in the mountains, I might be catching a cold. Emblem 3. The fledgling spirits of men were strong in old times. Unafraid to war with dragons and their voices. But the dragons only shouted them down and broke their hearts. Wow. People are leaving offerings. What would be appropriate, Garm? What would be appropriate? I guess. If I had to pick, I'd say juniper berries. Well, girl, we need to set up a camp somewhere before it gets any worse. Let's look up here. Don't need a huge spot. Just big enough. This looks good right here. Good job, girl. Alright. Got him out of our camp, didn't we? Alright, so we're gonna set up camp here for the night. Seems like a very long time since we used our camping skills, does it not? All right, let's gather up some dead wood. Five pieces. Go one more time. Yeah. Chop that dead wood. I think one of the things that's been really interesting for me about creating this story for you guys is it's been somewhat difficult for me to remain disciplined sometimes about staying on schedule with releasing these videos. And it's not at all an issue of releasing them too late. It's an issue of wanting to release them too early, being disciplined about not releasing everything I have as soon as it's done all at once. All right, having some trouble here. There we go. Because I find quite often that I'm creating episodes where I'm, you know, sometimes 6 or 7 episodes ahead of what you guys are all watching. And I always want everybody to be caught up. I want you to know what I know, you know, so we can talk about it. And I'm always anxious to see what, how people are thinking about, you know, the ways in which the story is developing and all these kinds of things. And it's difficult sometimes to be patient, you know? All right. And all of our food... Well, this... I guess we picked up this... Let's roast this leg of goat... That's good. Place the old cooking pot for fun, right? Hey, what you looking at? All right, well, let's warm up a little bit by the fire. And since we bothered to cook the leg of goat, let's eat the hot food, right? Some water, apple. Okay. I think the other thing, though, too, is it's pretty obvious now that we're going to need to change gear. So we're going to go with the heavy weather stuff. Everything else should be good, I think. We can put our necklace of rejuvenation back on now that we've located Garm. Feeling uplifted. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you for coming along on the journey with Etienne. And I look forward to seeing you in the next adventure through the passage. I'll see you next time.